E-Home's turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Dire team ban. Ten seconds remaining. Reserve time. E-Home's turn to ban. Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Beastmaster.
E-Home's turn to pick.
Hello, Dota TV.
Enchantress.
Welcome to the cast. IDG versus
Tidehunter.
For IDG Vitality versus E-Home.
Dire team pick.
Please stand by. You're about to start the Twitch stream. No? Put on your headset. We're gonna go live. Come on! Chop chop!
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
What? Yeah. Well, then we'd actually die.
Reserve time.
Come on. We do this. Yeah?
Invoker.
E-Home's turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Paul, but, you know.
Yeah, it's okay. Sorry. Okay, so we're already halfway through the draft in terms of pick. We got a Beastmaster Invoker opening on the side of IG Vitality, and E-Home went for the Enchantress Tidehunter, so tell me which opening you like better. I personally, I'm not an analyst, but Beastmaster Invoker is my favorite.
I'm gonna stick to the support and offlane combination.
Okay, okay. That's okay. I mean, there's a reason I'm an analyst, but can you explain more why?
Remaining.
Flexibility. Like, when you pick two cores right at the start, you have to be so confident. But I can understand why they're actually picking him for first. Because he got banned, like, in the games that they did.
Yeah.
They couldn't get the hero in the second phase, so it's either they get him in the first phase, or they don't get him at all.
Yeah, and we just saw Fran on his invoker actually do so much.
I would give for that guy, yes. Yeah. I'm on that. I'm on board of that.
He was so strong. Also, guys, we are aware of Twitch sounds, as in game sounds not being audible on Twitch. It might be fixed in a week. We tried some things, but we couldn't figure out if that actually did the trick. There will be someone else looking at it after this game or after this series to try and help us fix the problem. So thank you for those that mentioned it. We are aware and it's being worked on. Okay, so we have got Dandelion Dragon Knight and Death Prophet. The Dragon Knight being a bit out of place there, but we know that E-Home likes their Dragon Knight a lot. And then
Old Chicken likes his Dragon Knight.
Yes. And then we had the Doom and the Bounty Hunter and the Spectre removed on the side of Eholm. Why the Spectre straight away? What the...
You're worried? Because that guy plays a good Spectre. Even though he got caught so many times in
He got caught so many times!
That Rider was his, like, nemesis. He knew where he was going every time.
Yeah. I actually... I mean, I know he was good on the Ember Spirit, and we saw the Ember Spirit getting banned out in the second game that they played as well. But I wasn't impressed by Spectre that much.
He did a lot of work.
Yeah,
he also did a lot of work, yeah, that's the thing.
But he still... I feel like he got picked up too many times. Maybe that's a more a mistake in terms of... Because they should have more vision to know where he was and things. But
A few cases were him just being too far, he was just greedy.
Yeah.
So, he wasn't careful enough. Put it mildly.
He read the game situation wrong. He read wrong how far ahead they were. And we talked about this earlier, about how important it is to know where you are in the game and what you can and cannot do. Nubi was the king of that in the series that we watched. In terms of the two teams, who do you feel like is having the upper hand in that, in just a game reading? Are you ahead? Are you behind? How far can you go in the lane to farm? How far out can you go?
I think Eholm might be slightly better. Much more experience.
Okay.
But even in the game, I wasn't really impressed by their play in the first series that we watched Eholm.
They felt off. I think that Eholm in the group stages looked really strong. I like to see them play, and I think they just didn't really feel that crisp as they did in the group stages. Because... we've seen them do better. We know that they can do better.
Maybe it's a playstyle issue as well. Yeah, up against a different type of team that plays differently.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. But overall, it feels they're off today, like in the first series.
They did have a break while IG Vitality was playing, and they had the chance to watch Nubi versus IG Vitality, so perhaps they learned something there that, you know, will help them take them down. Keep in mind, guys, this is an elimination best of three. This is game one only, so there's still a chance after this game, but if you lose this best of three, you're not gonna go to Manila.
Are you going home?
They might be playing from home.
From their base, yeah.
From their basement.
Well, they used to be playing on LAN, right? Like, every time I noticed the Chinese qualifiers, they always played on LAN, so...
They did in the past, actually. They did at 4TI so far. They've done that 2 years in a row where they had, like, the qualifiers. In the
LAN environment.
In a LAN environment, and then after the qualifiers, there was a tournament with the teams. Organized by Mark Yu, I believe.
We'll see Eholm in a draw strat with Green Ranger.
Fast-paced game.
I actually like this compared to their previous games where they picked a lot of reliance on ultimates.
Yeah.
I didn't particularly like the tight Enigma game. I actually like this type of lineup more. You don't rely on the ultimate as much. Reserve
time. I like the Titan Enigma draft, it didn't work for them, which made it sad to watch. Because you never got to see what you wanted if you're a spectator.
I don't think you will see that type of draft too much nowadays, because it's difficult. It's just difficult. Like, everyone's playing fast-paced order, and you have to wait for ultimates to come off cooldown. That's not the way to play right now, it's very difficult. Darkseer. And Eholm has much better lanes this time. Like, I talked about how their lanes were weak in the first series today.
Is this a support Beastmaster then? So...
I guess so.
Yeah.
Greedy. The greed. I think they did this before, during the group's chairman. I recall a few teams that actually did jungling Beastmaster. You have jungling Enchantress, I have jungling Beastmaster, but obviously Enchantress is much more impactful early. Beastmaster need similar to Enigma. You need to reach level 6, then you're very useful.
Mm-hmm.
But before that, you're not so useful.
I like the Yuno Ember ban. It's scary.
That ducks here. So. But
yeah,
Enchantress is gonna help the tide. If everything goes the same way, like how everyone has been utilizing the Enchantress so far.
Yeah. It's gonna come down to the creeps though. We saw that.
Oh, Chuan was the.
Chuan was so lucky.
Was the luckiest Enchantress today.
Oracle removed. I would really like to see a Crystal Maiden on the side of Eholm. I don't think we'll see it, but I would like to see it. I haven't seen Crystal Maiden. Because I know that she's decent against Darkseer, or at least okay-ish. And I just really like to see Crystal Maiden.
They'll just pick Disruptor. Oh.
Most likely. Remaining. Or is it just for Vish still? I don't know. I don't think he's very good. She's very good against the Dark Seer on the lane.
Yeah,
but the auras.
Strategy. Yeah.
The auras are great. For IG Vitality, we're still looking for the Yuno hero for the core. Sven is still in the pool. Wouldn't be bad, actually.
I actually like Slark, though.
Yeah?
I actually like Slark. Okay.
E-homes I like Slark, too.
They like Slark, too.
Vision. I don't even know why I try.
They have good vision.
Yeah.
Good vision control from Beastmaster and Slark. We used to see a lot of Zeus Slark, but because Zeus is remaining. MIA right now.
Mm-hmm.
So you wouldn't get your easy...
He's on holiday. 5 seconds
remaining. Well, he's on a long holiday.
Unpaid.
How about Storm's holiday? He's on like some...
Storm is on a sabbatical. Taking a gap year. Okay, so E-Home, last pick. They need support. I mean, Venge is good for the auras. What else do we still have in the pool that would be good? You said Disruptor still.
Good versus Slark. Mm-hmm. So that'd be obvious against Slark.
Yeah, Lime was one of the first bans, so we won't
Venge
see that.
Venge is not so good versus Slark.
Okay.
So I expect Disruptor. Good versus Darkseid as well. That's the obvious picks. Venge is okay, like I mentioned. It's not so good versus enemies lineup, but it's good for your own lineup.
Yes. It depends on where they light a focus. It's gonna be a disruptor, so that will be it.
I mean, it just fits the lineup versus the slot.
Mm-hmm.
Other better reasoning for the pick here. So Slark, you force him into BKB because against disruptor, you have to get BKB because Dark Pact doesn't deal with the silence, doesn't deal with the glimpse. So that's one thing to note when you're playing Slark versus Disruptor. You get an early BKB. Maybe not first item, but second item, like after your Shadow Blade. I'm not sure if you can maybe you can delete Shadow Blade, Echo Saber, and then BKB.
You're one of the Echo Saber Slark fans.
What's wrong with that?
I heard
you don't like the item.
I personally see that. I mean, I see the appeal for the Slark more than I see for the Sven, even though I see the Sven as well. But I believe yesterday on the panel I had a discussion, or someone else had a discussion with someone else about Echo Saver or the Slark.
It's great. What's wrong with that? It's great.
I can't remember the discussion itself anymore. It's been a few days in terms of sleeping schedules and whatnot. So, but I know that there's some people that are not truly a fan of that. I don't know. The pause comes
up. You have to explain why. You can't just not like it.
Personally, I'm okay with the Saber.
You don't like it. It's obvious. Don't like it. You don't like it.
No. You can heal two times the stacks. It's good. I like. It's good against the Enchantress. Okay, so let's take a look at who's playing what. We have Yuno playing the Slark. Yes, I'm switched up. It's so good. Dogfight Dr. Fran.
You gave up.
And Super is playing the Beastmaster. In July, playing the Darkseer and on the side of E-Hole. Picking on the Windranger. That is old 11 on the Ranger. Don't like that. It's good madness set. Doesn't matter. Fenrir Disruptor. And old Lanham on his Enchantress and last. But definitely at least. It is Ice.
Daryl, Kor, Pei Xiang on the Watermelon.
Second time we see him on Tidehunter today.
One of his, one of his signature heroes.
Mm-hmm.
Tide, what else is?
I guess it's my signature hero.
Tide
too.
Prophet. Your signature hero?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. A different type of
hero. It signature. Doesn't have to be good to be a signature hero, okay? Besides, Ice missed the Ravage today as well.
So that goes for Venomancer as well, right?
Hmm? What?
You don't, because you said you don't have to be good to make it a signature. He goes to Melk when he plays Venom.
Yeah! And come with me with the Urshan. What? Oh, that's me. it's a load of spear. I'm thinking about all the ultimates that have like names.
Why a PG Black Hole? Yeah.
PG Black Hole?
Yeah.
I can't think of any more. The Doom. Let's Doom. Every coin helps.
Let's not, stray too far. Ban Invoker, yeah. That's when you know Aquila is a good item.
Yeah, he built the previous game too.
Yeah, everyone is building the same build already. Because if you go for the Gnarl build, eventually you have to sell the Gnarl because you have a you're gonna get best as well. And you're gonna have to sell the Gnarl because of the slot issue. So having the Wraith Band into the Aquila is a much better build for the Invoker.
My game is having nice lag spikes again, so I'll probably
try to... 0% packet loss, look at my PC.
Oh, Fran! What are you doing there, buddy? Pretend that the gas is so
fast. Best solve.
Best solve, but he's taking a large beating here. There's a self on Wind Ranger too. She's not really committing anything. Yeah, in the meantime, Enchantress is found in the jungle.
Wind Ranger has Draw Ranger Aura, Precision Aura. That's why he's right kicking harder.
Yeah, yeah, but it's like he's not it's not costing him anything. What Enchantress and Beastmaster doing? Like a... jump around.
This is a duo that Beastmaster cannot win.
Nope. He even loses his boar.
He's not a Doom. He can't fight.
Meantime, Azai's dealing with Dogfights. His casket on the bot lane.
Yeah, they need to wait until level 2 on Rich Doctor before they can post a threat to kill. Like, they need Meld so they can kill him. But mid lane, it seems like Wind Ranger is just continuously pressuring Invoker. Invoker has 2 CS, Rangers 8 CS, and 6.
So, I'm really tempted to reconnect here, but I don't. It feels like I might miss first because I.
No, you class me.
Okay. Oh, same last word, let's reconnect. Come on! No! He's almost getting the kill. He didn't get the kill though. Don't worry, guys, we didn't miss it. Oh, that was very, very close, however.
Trust. The trust.
The trust was there, but... it was not misplaced. You're fine, you're good. Meet them old Lanham coming in from the side, has got the troll, and waits for Windranger to push him around. Invoker's out of reach then completely. Windranger doesn't have a Windrun anymore until like 5 mana from now. Might be enough. The pressure is definitely there. In terms of last hits, Windranger is definitely...
He's gonna go in when the creeps push towards the Power Shiver. Here we go!
Nope. Yeah, and Chandra's he's waiting for the wave to pass.
Nah, he's not gonna go anymore, I think.
Are you sure?
If he wanted to go, he would have been going right now.
Hello? No, he's going now.
Oh, he's waiting? But the creeps are gonna die, you know, like when... I don't know, I'm not sure. I think he's hesitating.
Hello? Is it me you're looking for?
No, it's not.
No, it's not. Okay, so Chantress is wasting some time there. In the meantime, Knuff comes out and Old Chicken, he does have a Windrun and decides to move forward. He's like, Enchantress, are you coming? And no, he's not. And that's actually Old Chicken for his back. He has got the bottle though. He should be fine. Meantime, on the top lane, tied
on the courier. He got the courier.
Oh, almost. No, no.
He got the ensnare. I thought he was going to get the courier. Oh.
Still not worth it. Wasting time, Enchantress.
And Beastmaster not wasting time, jungling. Look at this Beastmaster, not wasting time.
Continuously farming, has got the Talon as well, making sure that he gets easily. In the meantime, Isis is level 3, he's not getting too many last, but that's fine, but he is still getting more than the Darkseer though. Darkseer is actually down quite a bit.
Yep, trying to, you know, a lot of damage. Helps to support zone. I met him before, this is really good at having one hero. But it's 2 heals, and Disruptor loses a lot of heat effectiveness.
Trover. 20 for 21. 23 nice at the moment.
Does Denies actually give gold?
No.
I think he thinks so. It's more deep thing.
It's exactly what you say though, it's like a lot of damage, and Iron Shell makes it so that the creeps die so gradually. That it's very easy to time your damage.
We really have enough damage. Free farming mid. Look at his CS.
Mid ranger, yeah.
Old Chicken. Having a good old time in mid lane.
Did we not previous games see Fran also have a tricky time on the Invoker and he was able to catch up?
Well, what was that match? Oh, was it Orange? No, it was. Oh, was it Puck? Oh, it was Puck versus Invoker. Well, we were talking. I was like, oh, Invoker should be doing better.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Another smoke, this time Disruptor is part of the party. Shackle, nice. It is enough setup. I can feel Both of them come to the chip and perhaps the kill, but then he dumps the stun trap and the first one goes to the Fenrir.
Good play by Lam. He was anticipating the strike immediately after the Cold Stab. Walk away with his wind lace. So he's really, really fast. 400 movement speed with Brown Boots top lane. Ice, ice, ice.
Teleports it out.
Hats off. 3 points in Kraken Shell, so you're not gonna kill that guy.
Really not. That's not really possible. Invoker back mid, he does get Beastmaster mid a little bit to take the experience that Invoker missed, but Beastmaster already retreating back to the jungle. And with Joe Ranger having such a good game against this this Darkseer, Disruptor is allowed to roll free right now. And that is one of the bigger things for Ae Hong's lineup, I feel, because that Witch Doctor is still stocked up. He is not allowed to leave that top end.
Yeah.
He does, the Doctor's gonna
no
be sad.
Thanks to this Beastmaster. He's gonna be level 6 soon. Still a good timing. Oh, he has Bounty Room. Okay, level 6. Let's go raw the Drowriger.
He's not yet 6.
They're pinging. Oh,
also,
it's actually better he's not level 6, so they're pinging now. He's level 5 still. He needs to farm. And then kills this M. Level 6. Runs down with the draw. That's the plan.
Is it a good plan?
Let's go, let's go, let's go. I wanna see the plan.
There's no
Fenrir right here with Hawk. Oh, he wants to kill Fenrir.
He doesn't have a Hawk.
Ah, he wants to kill Fenrir. No?
He doesn't have a Hawk!
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Look at this! He had a Hawk here! Come on, dude!
Oh, there.
Here!
Here! Don't worry. Well, they look for the Beastmaster. The Beastmaster just outjuked them.
Because
he had a hawk. And I didn't spot.
Smoke! Kill draw. Let's do this. Let's do this.
It's Witch Doctor that buys smoke. Actually, Super has one in inventory too. Witch Doctor rotating now as well. He's actually rotating towards the Witch Doctor mid.
Man, Invoker's getting destroyed.
Draw aura!
17.43. I haven't really seen mid matches go badly, like until this patch is much more evident. Oh, missed the raw. Didn't get the raw. That kind of sucks.
Very good ward from Ehelm.
Yeah, and Old Chicken was also positioned very well because they noticed Beastmaster's level 6.
Oh,
they
did the raw. Sunstrike as well. There is no wimple anymore. He did. That's surprising. We saw them, didn't we? I mean, there's a ward. Just went out, nice ward, you know?
And
should have seen. Oh, it was nighttime.
Yeah, I'm sure it happens. When your pups, you're peeing. Careful. Get back. You're peeing. And then all of a sudden, the guy still died.
Yep.
Like, oh, I thought
I'm normally that guy. That still ends up dying.
Like, sorry guys, I thought I could farm one more creep.
Yep, there's one more wave.
Just one more creep.
One wave is all that you need to do.
Just one more burger.
Burger. Thank you. Like some more cereal though.
Yeah, I noticed you're taking cereals a lot here.
I'm making cereal. So, Starburst too.
Of course they're good, they're full of sugar.
That's good. Okay.
Sugar's good.
So what's the timing we're looking here for Ehelm to try and I always say gonna say try and push. We already saw the Drow doing a lot of damage to the tier 1 bottom. Is there a moment where they're gonna try to group up and push like that, or what's their game plan?
Game plan, get levels, ultimate select. Oh, I hit block on Darrow. I find get Gravage.
If not, he shouldn't use it. Let's say he wants a good fight, and Jaws actually. He's waiting for the TP's coming in.
Oh.
Yeah, I've got the Beast, but he's stuck in a kinetic storm.
Oh my
and
god.
And not feel the glimpse. They don't think they do have to kill you know?
They
don't
kill
they did not get the fight, but they did get the other two.
You gotta take
your advantage where you can. This
I thought
not
he was
bad.
Actually gonna glimpse and the gap. He gotta kill you. I mean, which of the TP in front of him?
I don't think he saw the arc.
Oh,
like,
really?
He fast.
I see, okay. My bad.
Okay.
But overall, Ochikun gets power, so big victory there. And they get 2 return kills with the Ravage. So he baited there. He made it feel like I think I should get a kill by Khan. Because he had so many in Kraken.
Yeah. There's a smoke up from Super.
It's actually so fun when you're tight and you have so many points in Kraken and everyone's right clicking you, like, ah!
Roar! No, it can't! The change at cut point is in a danger! Stoop now in a lot of trouble, the shot won't latch, and he is a lot of people still can't get away. Arrows coming up, a defensive roar, but that's not what I want to use the roar for. Oh!
Cast point.
Cast point changes! All the 11! Not all that he's like, he's got like lightning fingers going on.
That's why. We always mention Dota is always part of the little things.
Yep. Cast point. So important. That's actually not a little thing, that's a big thing.
Yeah. Just like girls, it's always the little things that make them happy. The little things.
Not always. Wow. Let's back! Oh yeah!
Okay.
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 So Dinotra has got is going for the mech. I really like it because I think they're gonna use it just as a so
five man.
For the five man. It's like either we're gonna take your tower or you're gonna have to fight us, but if you're gonna fight us, you're gonna walk into a ravage.
Yeah.
And we will have the mechanism to back it up as well.
Yeah, that was a good point. Like, basically, sometimes you see types deciding between Blink and mech.
Yeah.
This is the type of game where you want a mech. Because the way you're going to play this game, you're going to position the draw and the window, you're hitting the tower with the end creeps, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't want to initiate on them. You want to wait for them to come in. So you build the mech, you stay behind, and if they're coming, you ravage. So that's basically how they want
to
play.
So that, you know, you don't have to build a blink if you you just have to people walk towards you.
Sometimes you want to build a blink, like an easy example to understand is against Keeper of the Light. He's spamming Illuminate behind the tower.
Yeah.
So you want to be able to jump him.
Yeah.
So against that you want to have the blink. But against what they want to do right now, having the mech is much better. I think that's
I like
a fair explanation.
No, it's good. Look at the difference between farm and Darkseer and Tide, by the way. This Drow Ranger rather has made sure that in July has
stayed in July last year.
Oh, he's like so last season, last year's fashion. No, his net worth is so low actually.
No. Our friend.
Oh, the shackle.
Ooh, Ravage committed. Roshan, are they going for Roshan? No, Tower.
Mechanism
Roshan
is
tower.
Done. Let's say Tower and Roshan. Why not? They push so fast and the tower is almost dead already.
So greedy. Oh yeah, the tower is low, okay. So tower plus Roshan. Possible Shiva.
It is possible. Possibilities are plenty. Yeah, we I mean for home they're looking so good. This Drow Ranger, I don't think I've ever seen like this many denies on lane from a Drow from anybody. Drow Ranger is 80-45.
I've seen him burning before when he was anti-mage against Darkseer. Mm. It's always against Darkseer because it happens on the Iron Shell.
It's so easy to time the denies. Well, if you're actually good at last hitting.
If you're actually
which, you know, is okay, that's the case.
Oh,
the
11! I see the fish! I don't want the fish to be next to me!
Sunstrike coming out, he's able to dodge that, but it doesn't matter. Actually, he was able to dodge most
big
of it,
kill.
But he still got it on the side.
That was the most valuable kill that he can get with the Shadowblade. So, IG Vitality gets the most valuable pickup.
How much did he get for that?
1,000 gold.
433 gold?
1,000 gold.
Black! Come back! Look at that, I'm clicking on the Diva Riga, but it doesn't appear.
Damn, just kidding. 400 gold.
433 gold.
And the other one's getting the Roshan. Oh, this is a big blow towards the draw lineup.
Yeah.
This is a big, big blow, and it's a grab. But do they know? They don't know.
They don't know. They don't have any wards up there. They had wards further up north.
Yeah.
But they now see the courier going there, so they have to assume. And they will know soon too. Tier 2 Toro will get pressured by the time that this Roshan is down. Do you think that IG would want to try and fight IG Vitality, that is? If Eom is going to pressure top tier 2?
They have a mech, though, mech advantage. I still think Eom are very, very strong 5 men, despite...
It will
ages.
Be 4 men, Joe's not there.
Dire's top tower. Come on, O11. Get up there, dude.
He just died! He
you're
just
a draw! You need to be with your team.
Well, they might try to go for
mid.
The bottom tier one tower
stays,
trade.
If he stays here, he might die if they find him.
Oh,
look at him! He just ran on it and shoots an arrow at him.
Just
the
dirge!
You deserve to die! O11, you deserve to die!
No, he doesn't! He has a gust!
No.
And it's an HMS team! Is there a focus right? There is, but he doesn't want to use it on the tower. They're just pushing this tier 3 tower right now.
And they're gonna
forcing everybody to back my IG fight. See, this is the fight though. There is a Ravage available if he wants to. Do they want to try? No.
Oh, Glimpse!
The Glimpse into the Static Storm gonna kill. They have the Sentry there as well, but there's no damage. They need to throw Ranger for this. Now they have the damage. Shackle a little bit too early to the Beehive. We have the Disruption. Disruptor, rather, getting roared. Beastmaster coming up to the side. These misses. Darkseer. Not Darkseer. Beastmaster dies. Yuna now comes back. Looking for a Shackle from Old Chicken again. Can't find it. If he would have saved the Shackle until the Aegis respawned, he could have Shackled like right after he respawned. I think that would have been nice, but I guess they were too busy with the Beastmaster on the back lines. Now that there's no Shadow Dance.
And there's still Ravage.
There's still Ravage. They're just gonna go again.
Okay.
Why not? I asked you. Oh, wow, did that cast still fly? That's a long range.
Why not? You like Echo Saber, Shiva.
It's not a very exciting item.
What? Then what item is exciting, Egan?
Blink Dagger.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can't go wrong with that item.
I like Bloodthorn is fairly exciting.
Nah. Bloodthorn is just inexpensive.
I think Hurricane.
You're not getting that item.
Hurricane
no.
Pike is
Hurricane,
exciting too.
Hurricane Pike is just OP. OP.
On some heroes.
Oh. On all heroes. Okay, some heroes.
There's a Slug. He's on the hunt. He has a haste rune. Won't find anybody worse now though. I mean, we were 16 minutes into the game and they were already pressuring tier 3 towers on the side of E-Home.
Draw line
up. E-Home pressures them. That's...
Draw line up, Shiver. Draw.
Yeah, but it's going very well for them and they didn't even have Draw there.
Where is your Dragonlance, Draw? Come on.
He needs some damage.
Oh, 11. Come on, Dragonlance, you have 1800 gold.
Did you say Hurricane Pike was good for the Draw?
Did I? Yeah, I did.
I remember that conversation this morning.
That's pretty decent. Positioning too is good. And good stats.
Good stats indeed. Okay. So.
Why is he always so far away from his team?
I don't know.
He doesn't like his team.
I think Yuno knows that he's not far away from his team. He's been hunting for him, but how he's actually with
his team.
He's
a Stark, he's supposed to be alone. That's fair.
They're gonna go for the tier 1 top then.
They're gonna
while
push high ground.
E-Home is pushing
push
mid.
High ground.
Yeah, they're just gonna go.
High ground? Abi?
Nope.
Going high
no.
ground?
Sorry.
Oh, they need to spend. Oh my god, let's have Hurricane Pike!
Yeah!
Yeah? I thought you hit the item. Oh, you like the item.
Look, the Hurricane Pike is fine. It's an exciting item. And Enchantress is really good.
How's that better than Echo Saber?
Because it makes people move!
Just have four stars, dude.
He has one, and he upgraded it. It does something.
You
there's
must,
something gimmicky that other things don't do.
Player,
there's a lot of other items that make you do more damage, make you be able to farm more. Like
you must
Echo
be
Saber.
A Pudge player, you like to make the enemy team move.
I'm a Pudge player, but I don't like watching Pudge play. I think most people like that play.
I really don't.
I'm a watcher of Exciting Dota.
No, you just like Blink kills.
Yes, so. That's Exciting Dota.
You don't like technical Dota.
I do like technical Dota as well, but I feel like it has to be balanced out. And if you're asking me what items I like...
You can't have everything, Shiva. Either one or the other.
No.
You're greedy.
No, you can have both.
Okay.
I think you definitely can have both.
Fight.
Shackle, that is dead Witch Doctor already looking for more. Tidehunter finds himself in July, who is going to try to teleport out and will be able to do so barely, but no other
oh, he didn't
protection.
Ravage him. He didn't want to ravage him.
No, Radiant's I don't think that would be a good thing too. He wants to ravage for the team fight.
That
when actually I foretell no wasn't.
That was
there was only two people and one's already dead.
Okay.
And maybe he thought they would
that was
kill.
A pick off.
Yes. Oh, blink forward, but Ran's already invisible. No detection coming out from Old Chicken.
Come on, Old Chicken, you have 4,000 gold.
No, it's 3,000 gold. What's he gonna 4, find?
4,000 gold.
He has 3,000 gold.
3,900 gold. And then you...
He didn't.
You top it up, then you have 4,000 gold.
Oh, you're not talking about Old Chicken. You're talking about
old the old dudes, okay?
I'm like, nope, he has 3,000 gold.
Friend, not this time.
Ooh, can he get him?
Oh.
Does he have enough damage? Yes, he does. He does have enough damage. Easy. That is a 800 gold away for Axe for Old Chicken.
Okay, that is actually Old Chicken.
Like, nope.
Oh, he bought something. What did he buy? He bought Aghanim? What?
Oh!
He bought
Aghanim! Okay, you actually found exciting items. Aghanim's Grovinger Maelstrom is one of the more exciting items, and out of excitement, Winter pulled plugs on his microphone.
Sorry.
Welcome back. I mean, you like this item.
Aghanim? No, I don't like that item.
Oh, come on, it's hilarious. Think of all the pushes he can do.
No! Dragonlance. Oh, you know,
he goes into a shadow dance. He's screwed.
Yeah. No mana.
He's screwed. He's dead. He gets. Okay. He's
Almost dead. Oh, what?
Keep you safe. He lives. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Oh! Radiant's courier has been killed. Okay, they do kill him though. They should kill him. But. Oh. Why would they do that? Okay.
What was that?
Okay, hashtag worth, you know.
Yeah, he made it worth. He also
he had half of the duration of his shadow blade remaining. He could have just found a spot and hide and wait for his mana regen for DP, and he would have been modified.
But for the courier.
Okay, maybe he would have been fine. Maybe they
dusted him up.
Maybe they would still be able to find him.
Yeah, they dusted him up. So
okay, fair. That was.
I was worse. It was definitely fun.
No, Aghanim.
Okay, Maelstrom Aghanims. Maelstrom
no,
Aghanims.
Dragonlance. I like Dragonlance.
Aghanims.
Hurricane Pike.
Did we see the Hurricane Pike work yet?
Nope.
I've not seen it. Like, I've seen it being built before on Enchantresses, but I haven't actually seen
Keep
it work.
Keep your camera on Old Lamb.
I shall. If I miss any extra kills, other than the ones that I already missed, I don't blame you. Oh, there's a scan! They use the scan, they know that there's someone there. And they know that he just went to the lane. They see him on the lane as well.
Hurricane Pike.
But it's fine.
Sorry. Can't find him.
Yeah. Okay, so Ehome. What's their time limit here? Do they have one, if any?
Are we using time rating?
No. In terms of having their strategy, they have a draw range.
I know. Sorry, I bet. Usually draw lineups expire like minute 30. You don't want a game to go over 40, basically. Like 40 is like maximum.
Okay. Well, 40 still have a long way to go. Then that's fine.
Yeah, but it depends on the overall state of the net as well. See what is he going? He's going BKB, like I mentioned. Second item BKB on slot against Disruptor. You don't have much of a choice. That's
yeah.
Slot.
What does Vitality wait on? What do they need to do
they're
to
not
get
ahead? They're not waiting for anything, they're just farming and farming. For them, they want to prolong the game
as long as possible.
As long as possible. Ehome are the ones on the timer. The longer that goes, the better it is for Vitality.
Okay, so if you're IG right now, you're just waiting for Ehome to push the issue and then you're just trying to... Do you try to counter-initiate or...?
Same. Yeah. Right. Fine kickoff. Okay. So you have vision. You have superior vision slot. Provides vision so you know where's the wards. And you have Beastmaster, you have the Hawk.
Yeah.
And you have Scan. And you have Sunstrike.
Everybody has Scan though. You can't use that as an argument.
Okay. Everyone has Scan.
Actually, right now, neither of the teams. Actually, Dire team has Scan.
Okay, gem is important.
Yes.
They have the gem on Disruptor. He just got it. I'm gonna pass it to the Tide. Or maybe the Windranger.
Yep, Windranger is the blink.
Even though the scores suggest Ehome ahead, but net worth 3k. Draw Shred against Slark, not that big.
What do you think Throw is doing? Hey, do you think he's going for Maelstrom? Like,
I guess
I know
so.
You don't like Axe.
That's
but...
the build you do if you have Axe. Oh, mid lane, Shackle, not gonna connect. You're gonna Shadow Blade away. Double damage on Old Chicken. And Old 11 is going farm bottom.
Very important to notice who is who.
And Old Lamb is actually in the middle lane with his Queen Pike. Where he still has not used it even once. So that is a waste of investment.
I think I need to reconnect again soon because this is
I'm
not...
lagging too. I just got 20%, like 30% second loss. It was zero all the while.
Well, maybe I should wait for until it smooths out a little bit then. You think I should? Look at this. Oh, you have the same.
Yeah.
Ha!
Why are you laughing? If you're lagging and I'm not, at least you can look at my screen. If you're both lagging, we're screwed.
Yeah, that's why I say, ha! It's not really laughing, it's more like a...
gesture
you know.
That we are both in the same boat.
Yeah. Ha! Look at us. So sorry. You know? He's actually... No, he pounces it out.
Getting better? Nah. lagging again. Okay.
I'm gonna reconnect. Someone's gonna die.
Someone's gonna die. Beastmaster. Don't reconnect. Someone's gonna die.
I'm not reconnecting yet. I'm waiting.
Someone's dying.
No, they're not. I'm reconnecting now.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Teenager screen, nobody died yet. They're trying Roshan to do Roshan,
dying.
Guys.
Roshan is dying.
But he's not dead yet. This actually worked out a lot, so if you're still having issues, I would suggest for you to do that as well. Chicken does take a lot of damage though! Just the winner, but he takes a lot of damage from the touchback. In the meantime, there's a fight going on right here. We got ourselves a Beastmaster that's already dropped. You know, going for the Enchantress. Enchantress drop all the damage!
Double damage!
Double stack, old chicken! Shackle in July, not able to surge away, and in July goes down as well. That is four dead on the side of IG Vitality, with Invoker the only one to live.
Ultra, the hero of the match, hero of the fight.
He just found a double damage. That's not on him. That's not his amazing play that he does that much damage. Drew Ranger did finish up a BKB before going for a Maelstrom. Buybacks are plenty on the side of IG Vitality as they try to force Ehome out of their base. As Winter said, they just need to prolong the game and they just need to force Ehome out of their
prolong the game by using buybacks. That's a price.
Yeah, it's a big price. It does job done. Ehome is a lot less aggressive. They're not slightly aggressive. I mean,
look at both of them, they're hitting one.
BKB on one, he just wants to get the right. Leave old 11 alone. He gets it though. Super very low once again. He already died. He's gonna die again. One hit with the button. A mechanism heals him up, and old 11 doesn't finish the job. Old chicken. Yeah, here in the dirt. Creates some chaos. Witch doctor. Okay, I'm not sure what that's about. Just force him back. That's enough. That wasn't actually gonna get a kill, and now that the witch doctor rolled is down, I wouldn't be putting it past the EM to re-engage, but they don't have Ravage anymore. They don't have anything anymore.
Cast point, Shiva.
Cast point! I mean, they can't lower the cast point of this man. Because then he actually comes to OP. So now at least you can blink away if you see it happen. Or gust him. Whichever is your fancy.
Good enough. Be home, Shiva. The Rex.
Yeah. 100%. They still have the Aegis though. They couldn't fight again. They're just gonna do it again.
It's gonna expire. Oh, I still have 3 minutes. 2.5.
Yeah.
Silver Age. So time to remove the Ski Kraken Shell.
Yeah.
And the Untuggle.
I'm not sure if that's enough though. Because Tidehunter, by the time that... the Slark is hitting with fans, he fails to stop. And he'll stand that nice.
Tidehunter.
He's still with the jump time. I think the jump is way better for the untouchable. Mm-hmm. Chat is actually fairly sticky.
It has refreshed. It has refreshed.
Oh! Fairly soon.
Very soon. Very soon.
Pressure top lane. They already got their three tower down quite
Where's the low. Team? They need to defend.
They still don't have a Maelstrom, so, but he has the Gloves of Haste, so it's not yet that fun to see, but. Oh, nice. Oh, I really like this.
I don't like this.
No, you don't. But it's so fun to watch. It's fun to play too.
You know, it's going for the.
Oh, you. Sir. Orc coming out of the wall. The back to the wall. See your fall to double left. Hey, does have a BKB that runs up with Saving him disrupted. Does go to the no. You know, looks for old left next. Mighty find him. Takes quite a bit of axe there. And will indeed be able to get it. It's not going to stop him from trying to run now though, but that's not going to happen. Shouldn't happen. The Shackle is there. In the meantime, the rest of the team of Vitality was not able to save or get anything else in return for that, you know, play. Shackle. Latches the Witch Doctor to a Hawk. And the Yule Scepter is not in time for Witch Doctor's life to be saved. 2-for-2, with Intern just still alive, and she has the edges, this should be turning into
Arax.
I say that, but he's still not getting it, and he's actually off high dead. Well, for now. Anyway, this being that is boring, which I agree with as well. Meantime, the middle range breaks are under attack as well. The Shackle does latch in July. There, good. Didn't see the man there, old chicken. pops a BKB and the wind run gets away for now. Don't want to force any issues there on the rocks. They'll get some just extra because she bought time with the creeps.
I'll tell you a story about Ranger. Okay. If she doesn't die here.
Okay. She does not die there. Because Fran missed the tornado or Wind Ranger juked the tornado very quickly.
I had a friend telling me, you know, I had a dream about Wind Ranger. I have a dream where I'm on 1 HP, I pop my BKB, I pop my Wind Run, I TP in front of 5 heroes.
Okay. You say you had a friend, why is he no longer your friend?
Oh, my friend said that.
Sure.
And no one had MVP on the enemy.
At least, you know, it's a very, the dream's not very ambitious.
How is that not ambitious?
Well, because it's under only attack. One plane donut doesn't actually win you the game.
Yes, with 5-man gank.
Oh, Radiant used the scan. Actually, the position, this is scan. Does scout out the Dire that you see, you know, though. He goes into his BKB, into his Shadow Blade, now the tornado and peek comes out from Invoker. Dice, an old chicken. Get forced back. See Wurt there, with Ranger having gem still. Looks like Eho is gonna pressure. Again, look at the draw on the minimap. They know exactly where they're going. They're gonna go through it to top. Why do they think this is the right time to go? What's cooldowns are on cooldown, or is it just a timing hit? What's that?
Because the slot just popped BKB.
That's it. Yeah, I saw the BKB, but it's already up for 40 seconds. It's not like it's gonna be the
and
end of the
Shadow
world.
Shadow Dance, if they run now, there's no ulti from slot.
Shadow Dance is 20 seconds away!
Yeah, but they hit the Rex now, Shiva.
Yeah,
look at
okay.
It, they're hitting the Rex now.
Fair enough, tornado coming up. Get Ravage actually catches both the Witch Dark and Hope on the edge of the shackle! Up a super dog fight! One already down in July, it's been next one if he's not careful. He's trying to search that away, won't be able to do so because Enchantress just finishes him off. In comes the second Ravage Invoker, caught by that again. Fran, you. In the meantime, Yuno's stuck in the next kinetic field and. Fran, now just with the structure open, trying to turn this fate around as he. As well, Fenrir running away from the Tidehunter illusion. In the meantime, the melee racks are running Rex in the mid lane already dropped. It is just Tidehunter and Invoker back here. Destruction coming to Frey very soon as Duff fights. Yeah, you're. I tried the Oblivion back on the Beatmaster. What?
Oh, I bought that. Yep, fun.
Invoker did buy back. And Beastmaster comes back in. Yes! Not gonna work. I think he might be able to kill Enchantress. They do quite a bit of damage.
Yeah.
Is she though? No, she's not. Anchor Smash coming out as well, helping out. There's a heal in 15 seconds, and I'm dead. But Fran, nice to win! The dieback on the Invoker!
One plus one. Beastmaster.
Beastmaster for the gem. That's good for him. The dieback on the Invoker, though. That's seconds. Ooh, what happened to
Hey!
That's Beastmaster for you. I figured why so late into the fight, but now we know why.
Are you sure?
Yes.
I was watching. I was looking at your screen because mine was lagging so much. Now they have to push bot.
They do. But that's convenient because maybe they wanted to do this anyway and leave the creeps to take top. Like, they would have wanted to have one.
They would have wanted to get top. So.
I mean, E-Home, even if they lose all the racks, if you have a Draw Ranger on your team that has Maelstrom or even Mjolnir, you're good. You can deal with Mega Creeps so easy.
So you're saying that he went for this build in anticipation getting racks?
No. I'm saying that it is a nice, you know, it's
That's
a nice addition
saying.
To his build.
Oh, they actually knew that they were gonna get racks.
Yeah. It's a nice addition. The Maelstrom didn't really work out in the push on the top lane though. Because you do need to stand still and hit a few people in order
and
to get the lightning.
You know what would have worked? Dragon Lance with the range. He would have sieged at a safer range.
Maybe.
What?
But you know came in from the back, you know? You pulled out a cable again. Well played, Winter. Well played. I think... I like Draw Ranger with this
build. I'll just leave it on the left so I don't pull out.
Leave it on the left. Okay, so Now that we are 34 minutes into this game, the gold grass is still very evil, but it is plateauing a bit. Wait a second, Juno, he's getting the tower and backs up. Whoa, chicken, he's still gonna go for this though. He knows where he went, looking for the shackle, perhaps. Where's the vision? Oh god, they have the gems on the Beastmaster, so there's no more gems on the side of Eholm. Did they buy a new one? Oh, they did. Enchantress has a gem. Beastmaster dropped one of them in the base.
I'm done.
That's now Slark.
I have to reconnect.
Okay. Oh, the courier has it now. Okay.
If I reconnect, you might lag, because that's how it works.
What?
Yeah.
That's not how that works.
If my PC doesn't lag anymore, you might lag.
But we both of us were lagging a moment ago.
Okay, seems good now.
Seems good.
Yay, not lagging anymore.
Great.
Are you lagging?
Not right now.
Okay, good.
Roshan will be up in just a few seconds. That will be the next point of contention. Keep in mind, they have that gem. They see Juno, they're looking for the shackle. They found it as well. He doesn't have the dark pack and he's dead. No cell can 70 arrive. Seconds, no buyback. That's Rosh. Is that enough?
Rex? Are they going Rex? I think they can go Rex.
They need to have a lane pushed out. None of their lanes are pushed out right now.
Mid lane. They can push the mid.
Fran just pushed out mid lane as well. In the meantime, the bot lane is pushing and they need to do something against that. Because we still also have the Dark Seer over there.
Oh, they're going for Rosh. Yep. Easy.
Yep.
Bloodthorn on Windranger.
Is it?
No.
Did he?
I think it's good on Windranger.
Oh, Courier! In July! No, it doesn't get it. Has fallen to the ring. Okay, Dro gets it. In
all
the meantime, all the lanes are pushed out indeed, so that's good news for Vitality. It means that if something will happen after the Slark is back online.
That is correct, Shiver.
It's good news for them. Well played by IG Vitality to minimize the damage there by having those lanes pushed out. And making sure that is done. On the downside for IG Vitality, with all these gems in the game, there is very, very little vision, and I feel like that's a little bit more important for them than it is for Eholm right now. Am I right in saying that, or is that it's both just as important for either?
I think it's important for both, though. Vision is really crucial.
Mm-hmm.
So Eholm is gonna... I think it's gonna run down top. Not gonna take care of bottom at the moment, because top has no tower. It's easier to get their axe. They have the Aegis.
Ooh. Pause.
Can I go to the toilet?
No. If you go to the toilet, I need to go to the toilet. And then we both have to go.
And then we'll just get Rob to come here.
I guess. Thank you. Oh, he can hear that too. That's not nice.
No, he can't. Can he?
He can. I said I just insulted him while he could hear me. That's not nice.
Sorry, Rob.
I remember I went eat marshmallows with Rob once. It was very successful.
I remember going to rock climbing with Rob.
Rock climbing?
Yeah.
Okay. That sounds a little bit too dangerous for my teeth.
Indoor rock climbing.
Still not safe. Well, I guess it's safe, yeah.
Because he said that there's a lot of girls there, so I just followed him.
Oh! There's not! No! That's not where you pick up girls. Sorry.
Yeah.
Were there a lot of girls at rock climb?
With their boyfriends, yeah.
I guess it's a thing to do on a date.
Rock climbing?
Yeah, it's like
not a Malaysian thing, for sure.
No, but I can imagine that it's like normally people go for a date, they go out for a drink or for food or something, or people go to zoos or things. But rock climbing can be really nice too.
Yep, the guy will be standing at the bottom side waiting for the fall and to save her.
Yep, and I mean you got a good view of the bottom as well, so there's that.
That's not... they don't dress up in skirts. Just
no, but shorts. I mean normally if you go rock climbing you wear one of those harnesses. And everything's really tight. So you went on a date with Rob, rock climbing.
And with Grace.
Lovely. Wow, this is getting more kinky. Let's talk about Dota. Okay, so we have an unpause. So talk to me about the state of the game for both teams.
Kinky.
Who needs to do what? Who is that?
My CEO is in control.
Yes.
It's the Aegis.
Yes.
They're gonna get bots on the ground. Drops go max to defend. Gonna tell the threats for drops for boost travel.
Mm-hmm. So she will defend and come top to help with the fight. You can do that. She also picked Mjolnir, by the way.
5 minutes ago.
What is 5 minutes ago?
She finished her Mjolnir.
Oh, I didn't see that yet.
I still need to go rock climbing.
Hi. Does that improve my eyesight?
Your attention.
Does it?
Yeah, it does.
Why?
Too much of the same thing in that. Like, too much to, you need to walk.
Oh.
So, points of travel. And here comes Yuno on the side.
Yeah, Yuno looks for it.
No buyback on Slark.
Oh, they see him though, they see him. Looking for the shackle. Chicken is trying to tank that up. Doesn't find the shackle to the tree somehow. I don't think it didn't latch.
But there's nothing to... How is that supposed to latch?
There's a tree!
He's here. He fired it from here.
Yeah, so there's like a tree there.
No! There's no tree there. That's too far.
Oh, I thought it would latch. And so did old chicken.
Confirm not Wind Ranger player.
I am a Wind Ranger player, so is old chicken.
But Dota says it doesn't latch, so Dota was right.
Yes.
Can't affect Dota.
Oh, the ladder, please. Careful, yes, he can be. He might be forced to pop it as well. He gets the gust off. He's fine.
Okay.
Not sure what a PK would have done.
Down, let's go.
Yeah. And for that. Nope. He'll fine. He'll be fine. I want to try and pressure this. In comes the Blink and Huntress up the high ground. Nobody there though.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Some hawks flying around.
You see, he bought the hurricane egg the whole game. He hasn't used it on the enemy one.
He hasn't used it. Yeah, I noticed.
Ah, told you, Dragonlance better. Better item than Hurricane Pike.
It's fun if it works though. But yeah, you're absolutely right. But you also, if you want to use it, you need to be able to have a way to see to have the vision still, and something that they lack right now. They don't have a ward of the high ground. In the meantime, here comes Dro going for the racks, and we'll get that. Gets the ward there as well, going for the next one. And after that, the fortification comes out. After that, they need to go back. They get the roar off of old 11, but no follow-up damage at all as the Ravage comes out of Zark, and oh, he dies! Second Ravage up on two, both in trouble, one already down now, and July come in with the vacuum, with the wall. Is it enough? This might be able to get something done. The Center Storm didn't actually do anything. The Aegis just popped at the Drow Ranger, but she's been trying to teleport out, but I don't think she will be able to make. He is dead. Nice defense. That's Dark Seer for you. It's old 11.
She is dead.
Old 11.
What? It's a she.
Old 11 is a he.
Yeah, but the hero is a he, so yeah. You have to use she.
But I said old 11, didn't I? Didn't
no,
I?
She's dead. He's dead.
You know what I mean? It's what I'm saying.
They got the range back on me, so...
Yeah.
Not good enough.
Not good enough, and I actually thought for a second that they could do it, but that Darkseer just turned everything around.
Darkseer plus the Meteor.
Plus the Meteor. The Goma was there. That's pretty good though. One Rax at a time for E-Home, but they will get pressure now. They have back on the Disruptor who won't get in, on the Drow, who I don't think will need it, but they might be forced to use it here. Do you think they will force to use it? Nah, 26 seconds? They should be able to hold. They got a win rate that has... Yeah, they should be able to hold. Should they? Glimpsing back into the kinetic field, turns on his BKB, Yuno into trouble, the Aurora already out of old chicken, he's gonna be the first target there. Tries to get away with his BKB there as the Witch Doctor is forcing everybody back, but doesn't actually get a kill there. He comes up high, doesn't have a Ravage, will be seeing the Meteor, Ram, trouble, gets focused fire, will be forced away and lives. As Witch Doctor, oh, that's cute, he actually gets up! In July, I'd not be so lucky because he is the one that gets focused, interrupted with his blink or with his support as well on that.
Down. 90 seconds, Shiva.
Slugger 90 seconds. Drow Ranger didn't have buyback. This is the time.
To end the
game. No, it's not. Beastmaster saying it's not. He's already putting bottom together with Invoker.
Yeah, but Drow can defend that.
She's not here.
She's gonna run back to base to defend that.
Wind Ranger actually still bottom lane. Does Wind Ranger have boots of travel? No, she'll stay bot to defend. Shackle! Oh! Oh, buyback! Beastmaster trying to put out there for the kill! Oh, nice for Drow to use it for! Just the Beastmaster, but with this chance here, the game, if they kill Super, no buyback For the Slark, Beastmaster can buy back, so can Darkseer, but I'm not sure if that's enough at all. Drow Ranger did teleport bottom as well, by the way, so there's just an Enchantress and a Disruptor to push the lane out, so I'm not sure if that's enough.
Drow has boost off the parallel.
Yeah, but where is she? Why is she not coming yet?
She wants to push up bottom lane, I guess. Yep, she's good. She's good to go.
Well, at least they still push out. That's fine.
I just got this screen right here. You're getting so much damage from the precision aura.
Yeah, it's really crazy.
Oh, this should be game. They can secure the last rack. Let's see, one more rabbit. Oh no, there's no more rabbit.
There is a rabbit, just refreshed. Just a second ago, he refreshed, so we will have that. Oh, take the fox to BKB. Drow Ranger now comes to the base as well. In comes a roar in all chicken. Hey, the shackle though, and the ravage coming in. Juno might be able to make something happen here. Goes an old 11, but old 11 gets glimmered, and that might be enough. With us there as well, Juno can't do anything. Neither can July. I believe that would be the game. Oh, EO, take it one. It's the best of three. Don't worry. IG by 70 still has a chance. Back to wall. Nice try though. Very nice try. Invoker is the last one alive. Mega creeps are up. Invoker did the best could. What do you think, Winter? No, GG.
I mean, the game got was almost getting worrisome for EO when they lost the bottom rack. But
yeah.
Otherwise, the whole game was thoroughly well controlled by them.
The Drow strat strikes again.
Strat.
Indeed. So that was game one of the best of three series.
Beastmaster, greedy jungling.
Yeah.
Good versus Enchantress.
You think
Enchantress bullied their lane though a lot.
And I think Beastmaster got a lot. The downside was Beastmaster got his levels in time. He just